Welcome to Sunday's Primetime Tonight, your inside look at cable TV, coming to you every half hour during your primetime viewing hours. Movies are coming your way in just a few minutes. HBO presents the movie Last Rites. Raucous golf course adventures come your way with Caddyshack on Cinemax. Continuing on Showtime is Dominic and Eugene. Next on HBO, Tom Berenger stars as a New York City priest in Last Rites.
I murdered my husband. Give me a penance, Father.
Another way out of here.
They know too much.
You know, talk to the feds.
He was married to the daughter of Scarlett Barty, a mafia godfather. You scare me.
You scare me, too.
Here are the sports coming this half hour. Catch swamp buggy races on American Sports Cavalcade on TNN. Get the highlights of the week's games on NFL Primetime on ESPN. The dramatic programs and comedy specials. The Disney Channel presents A Conversation with Bob Hope. Discovery Sunday examines American pastimes on the Discovery Channel. Nickelodeon brings you the gang at Green Acres. A&D presents the documentary The Fatal Attraction of Adolf Hitler. Next on the Disney Channel is the exclusive world television premiere of A Conversation with Bob Hope.
No, honey, I've kissed a lot of girls in movies. I kissed all of them, you know, Lana Turner and Anne Margaret, Raquel Welch, Trigger.
Timely news reports and the latest weather in just 1 minute. CNN World Report brings you uncensored news from around the world. Lifetime has cardiology update for physicians. On the Weather Channel is your local forecast. For an in-depth look at the day's most important stories, watch Headline News. Later tonight on the Weather Channel, get the weather conditions of interest to boaters and beachgoers on the Boat and Beach Report. Now, here's a recap of the shows coming up in just a few moments. Primetime Tonight. We'll be back in 27 minutes with more cable TV highlights. Stay tuned now to the Weather Channel for your local forecast.
Well, we'll take a look at this evening's weather. First of all, the satellite view. Lots of clouds into Montana, Wyoming, South Dakota. That rain is changing over to snow now as those temperatures drop down. Around Pierre, South Dakota, Aberdeen is still rain, but Rapid City has been snowing now for about 2 hours. So eventually it will be turning over. Also, some scattered rain showers in the southeast. We've got clouds to go along with that. Here's your temperatures now. 21 degrees up there on Sault Ste. Marie. Well, it is still 71 down in New Orleans, Louisiana, and very foggy across the Gulf Coast. We have a stationary front sitting there. That's kind of contributing to the air mass. It's very stagnant, not moving, not a lot of airflow down here. Therefore, we got a lot of moisture in the air, and it's very, very foggy. Temperature also, we got 49 degrees out here into parts of New Mexico, 57 degrees now in Los Angeles. Speaking of the Southern California area, we have some video out of there, out of LA today, and it was pretty nice. Some pretty nice conditions out there. We'll be back with more weather.
This is Weather Watch.
Good evening, Cindy Preszler and Mike Bono. You're watching the Weather Channel, and it's still kind of rain, snow mix into South Dakota, but we think by tomorrow morning, all the state of South Dakota will be in the form of snow.
It looks that way. In parts of North Dakota, Minnesota, back on into Wyoming and Colorado, that's the focus of the morning travel problems. We'll take you through that morning right now, first of all, with the current weather. And we can see that we do have quite a bit of cold air coming on down through Great Falls, Montana. It's still snowing there. It's been snowing for quite some time with 19 degrees, about 22 in Bismarck, and the snow is moving on into that area. 28 in Duluth. These are all places which will be getting pelted with some pretty heavy snows tomorrow. On into the Great Lakes, it's cold. The stage is set for that snow to move up there, but some drying going on in the west, like 57 degrees in Los Angeles, 63 in Atlanta, and much cooler toward the northeast. We could show you some pictures, though, today into Los Angeles, and a sign of things to come. That front whipped on through there, cleared the air nicely. Now they'll have some good visibility for days, and there could even be some Santa Ana winds coming in during the week. A breezy week, you could say, with some drier and warmer air moving into Los Angeles. It'll probably get up to 80 or possibly more by about midweek. We've got our map for you to show you exactly what's going on in the west. Low pressure moving now into the high plains. In its wake, there's still a lot of upper level energy. The snow down the Rocky Mountain chain, the Wasatch of Utah into parts of Colorado, the wind into the southwest, and very cold air coming down from Canada. Still some messiness left over in the northwest, but looking better south of about Oregon. Some snow left over around Lebanon and Caribou, and some fog developing in much of Dixieland. There's that snow still moving through northern New England, but it's headed on out. Some showers in Florida and rain in the upper Midwest turning to snow as the ground gets a little bit higher. We have your local weather right now, then we're going to take you through the good evening forecast on into the look ahead.
On Monday morning, we'll have rain running ahead of that frontal system. In the warm front, the warmer air, but snow into North Dakota, which is getting the snow tonight. Back that off around Salt Lake City. They've picked up quite a bit of snow. Also into Wyoming and Colorado. The ski resorts really are happy now. Finally, they got some snow out there. This little cold front's going to drag back down into Texas by noontime. Rain developing along it into Memphis, Tennessee, Louisville, Kentucky, and by late in the afternoon on Monday, high pressure fills in out west. We do have another disturbance bringing some rain down from the Gulf of Alaska. That'll be into Washington and Oregon, but the Plain States will be clearing out by late in the day, and this time we'll have to look for that snow and that rain to head for the East Coast. When you melt down the snow, you'll get at least a half an inch, maybe a little bit more than that, tenth of an inch in the outer areas. Snowfall potential could be quite heavy, anywhere from 6 to 12 inches in this dark purple swath that goes way up into northern Michigan and Wisconsin. Tonight's lows, cold up here, especially when the wind kicks in. Wind chill factor will drop them way down. Mild, though, in the southeast, 50s and 60s, and the air is not moving. That's why we have all that fog down there. And as far as our highs on Monday, another mild day, 80s into South Texas and Florida. And wherever it's snowing and the wind is blowing, bitter, bitter cold temperatures up here in the Plain States. Here's a jet stream for you, and we'll pull that trough way down. Cold, cold air by the end of the week. Push it off the coast. We'll let high pressure fill in out to the west coast, dry things out, and have a pretty nice week for the west coast. Let's take a look at those temperatures now. The single digits, the teens, the 20s, that moves east with that storm system making its way off to the northeast. Mild conditions, though, in the desert areas of Southern California and Arizona, 70s, maybe in some 80 degree temperatures as those Santa Anas kick back in. And by Friday, everybody is back to normal. Christmas tree shopping season now. There's the winds again, the Santa Anas in Southern California, the Chinook winds into Wyoming and Montana. Rain for the East Coast, remnants of that storm. More snow moves to the northeast, the Plain States. Much of the country will be dry by Thursday and Friday. We'll push it all to the northeast. Mike?
Thanks a lot, Cindy. We'll have much more weather here on the Weather Channel. We've got the Traveler's Update detailing all that heavy weather that's expected to move through the northern plains.
Hey, guys.
We found a cool new way to get vitamin C.
Really?
No kidding. Look, new nice vitamin C drops.
Yeah.
You get a full day's supply of vitamin C in every cool, soothing drop.
Well, what do you think?
Real
tasty.
Cool.
New from those cold experts at Nice.
The beauty, the thrills, and the sheer fun of speeding down the side of a mountain combine to put millions of skiers on the slopes each year. Of course, the quality of the snow on the slopes, as well as the weather, determine to a great degree how good the skiing will be. So to get the latest ski conditions and forecasts for ski resorts across the country, watch the Skiers Forecast on the Weather Channel. We cover resorts in the east and west in separate reports throughout the day. Get the only hourly national forecast tailored especially for skiers. Watch the Skiers Forecast on the Weather Channel, brought to you in part by Nordica.
Buy any original classic model contour chair, and I, Art Linkletter, will send you your choice of a fabulous 19-inch Panasonic color TV, microwave oven,
or VCR. But don't buy a contour chair for one of these.
Get one because it's the most restful, healthful chair you ever relaxed in. Contour chairs help to relieve low back pain, poor venous blood circulation in your legs, edema, and swelling of the legs.
Call toll-free and get full details on our fabulous offer.
I chose the Panasonic Color TV.
I took the VCR.
I got the microwave.
Hello. I'd like to have your catalog and certificate mailed to me free.
Certainly, sir.
See how easy it is? Call for your free catalog and certificate right away.
Call 1-800-858-3300. That's 1-800-858-3300. Toll free. Call 1-800-858-3300.
It's Traveler's Update time right here on the Weather Channel. Going to that radar map, we still see some rain headed on toward around old North Bend, Oregon, up toward the Astoria area. Not all showing up on radar. Snowing pretty heavily in parts of the Montana Rockies still. Colorado Rockies, again, radar has trouble penetrating those mountains. But you're getting whitened in that area, on into the Bighorns and the Laramie Mountains, and even the Black Hills of South Dakota turning white. East of there, still some rain coming down. And on into New England, some snow through the Connecticut River Valley up to the western mountains of Maine. Some showers starting to advance into parts of Alabama and still through central Florida. The wintry travel is a big story tonight. The Cascades, the potential for some, right down to the Mogollon Rim of Arizona, the mountains of New Mexico, Sangre de Cristo, San Juans, you name it, through the Rockies. Then the high plains really starts blowing and snowing onward to tomorrow. Just south of that, the rain and the Gulf Coast beginning to erupt with some showers. Watch out, though, on the northwest coast for some rain, too. Winds gusting over 30 in the southwest deserts and locally up to 50 where that snow starts piling in the upper Midwest. The foggy travel low looking something like this, a crescent in the northeast. Plenty of that stuff on into the southland and even the Pacific coast, too. Your local weather is coming right up.
First Christmas together, I wanted to get Frank something exciting. The next year, I wanted to get him something informative. But this year, I really found the perfect gift.
A subscription to USA Today.
Terrific!
Call now to give USA Today for the most informative coverage of the event shaping the nation, along with the USA's most exciting sports section, loaded with stats and stories he won't find anywhere else, and personal finance with unbeatable advice, plus tips and tidbits on just about everything that interests him.
And I got some great gifts, too. An AT&T long-distance gift certificate, a beautiful brass tree ornament, and a handsome card to announce my gift. All free.
And I get color and excitement 5 days a week. Instead of once a year.
Call now to give 13 informative, exciting weeks of USA Today for just $29.25. Or give a full year and save 25% and get even more free long-distance certificates. Call now, 1-800-527-5800.
Take a look at that look-ahead forecast now with the jet stream. The jet stream has a lot to do with the airflow, the cold air and the warm air. Of course, the cold air stays north of this jet. The warm air settles into the south of it. This means a ridge of high pressure building out here. This is a very deep trough. Cold temperatures come back to the southeast again this week. So you bundle up, make sure you have that winter coat ready to go again. The west coast is going to be drying out as well. Here's those temperatures now, the teens and the 20s as of Tuesday. 40s reaching into Amarillo, Texas.
At
Alta Ski Resort, over 4 inches of water equivalent. Wind chills running 11 degrees in Salt Lake City, minus 11 now as the cold air has moved into Rapid City. 22 degrees right now, the wind chill in Minneapolis, St. Paul, 30s all the way down towards northern Arizona. National radar, you can see the rain and even some snow mixed in. Here's the rain around Wisconsin and the rain in Florida. A little bit of light rain, some ground clutter here around Lake Okeechobee, some isolated showers to the north and to the east. As we check out the rain, though, and the snow, here's the snow. Rapid City, the fastest city I know of in South Dakota, bringing the snow and the wind. And the wind is about as fast as Rapid is. As we check out those showers and even a few isolated thunder showers with some sleet thrown in north into North Dakota. That's my sign to say we're coming up with a local condition.
The current conditions. Stay tuned for more weather coverage here on the Weather Channel.
We'll go ahead and check out early morning Monday, and this is the commute we're talking about in Minneapolis, St. Paul. A slow go in the snow, as they would say. As the snow continues to accumulate during the day, there will be 6 to 8 inches in a swath from parts of South Dakota into Minneapolis and around Aberdeen and up to the north around La Crosse, Wisconsin, and eventually into Marquette, Michigan. It is going to be a very, very snowy kind of a day. Some thunderstorms popping up midday Monday, late afternoon Monday. It is going to be a mundane and a manic one in Chicago as the thunderstorms roll through. Even Detroit could see a thundershower. The thundershower south into the Petroplex, over towards the Metroplex, up into the Triplex of Texas. Looking at the potential for rain, we're talking about half of an inch of equivalent water. Some of it snow, some of it rain. Mostly snow in Wyoming, where there could be another 6 to 12 inches of additional snowfall. And you can imagine with the wind in here, we will probably see drifting snow making the roads very difficult to travel on. Monday, temperatures in the teens, 20s, 30s, and 40s further south, and some warm 60s in the southeast with highs back into the 70s, and if you can believe this, 80s in Texas, teens and 20s to the north. As we take a look ahead, we'll show you that jet stream, which is propagating from north to south. It's the old snake jet stream as it sort of curlicues its way across the country. Watch what happens by Friday as an elongated low pressure lollygags its way towards the east. It is going to be a plethora of weather to talk about. Let's talk about that plethora of weather. Highs on Tuesday and Wednesday, very chilly across the east. In fact, a rather cold pattern extends on into Thursday and Friday with only slow warming from Texas into the southwest, where there will be some Santa Ana winds on your Tuesday, Chinook winds as well into Montana and Wyoming. And here comes that rain and snow in the northwest. Hey, there's the east. Say goodbye to that big snowmaker as it rolls out towards the northeast. But here comes the Alberta Clippers, the Saskatchewan Screamers, the Manitoba Maulers, and also the Great Lakes Grippers. Sounds like a baseball team, doesn't it? Anyway, lots of cold air coming in this week and continuing to bring the thrust of Canadian air southward. It's more like a fall weather pattern. No, it's more like winter. Or is it fall, finter, winter, finter, sprummer, spring, summer, sprummer, summer? Anyway, one of those. We'll check it out. There's your Weather Channel update. Going out in a wild style here tonight.
It's 50 degrees at the airport.
Same old problem. The temperature isn't the same at your house as it is at the airport. Seasonal Solutions solves that problem with the Weather Channel digital thermometer. It measures the inside temperature, the outside temperature, and tells the time, all for only $19.95. Now you'll know the exact temperature whenever you want it, wherever you are. Put the Weather Channel digital thermometer in any room of your house, your office, or even your car. With its remote sensor, you can get the temperature inside or out with the flick of a switch. The highly accurate sensors measure temperatures in intervals of 1/10 of a degree. Compact and smartly styled, you can place this indoor-outdoor digital thermometer and clock anywhere, in its mounting bracket, on a windowsill, a nightstand, in the kitchen, or wherever you want to know the temperature and the time. Call now to order the Weather Channel digital thermometer. Your satisfaction is guaranteed.
To order by credit card, call now, or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $4 shipping and handling to Seasonal Solutions, Box 6348, FDR Station, New York, New York, 10150.
Earthquake experts predict for our future. It'll shock you. Watch On Shaky Ground, Saturday and Sunday, December 9th and 10th at noon, 6 and 11 p.m. Eastern on the Weather Channel.
Welcome to the world of government auctions. Did you know that the United States government wants to sell you cars, boats, homes, and real estate at bargain prices? In some cases, they're selling things at prices so low, you'd think that they're practically giving everything away. They have cars, boats, office equipment, and homes seized from drug dealers. The government has homes and real estate they want you to buy. Do you want any of these bargains? Call now and find out what you can get right here in your area. Federal, state, and local government agencies want you to come to their auctions. And now you can find out about all of these auctions and more by getting your copy of the Action Guide to Government Auctions. Do you want a car, a boat, a home, office equipment? Call right now and find out what's available. One man went to a government auction and bought a $50,000 boat seized from drug dealers, and he paid only $10. Get your copy right now. Operators are standing by to take your order and to tell you what's available in your area. Call 1-800-822-2470. That's 1-800-822-2470.
For 20 miles along the Gulf of Mexico, you can enjoy a vacation that includes everything from rest and relaxation to adventure and excitement. Panama City Beach is famous for its mild year-round climate. The mean temperature is 68 degrees. Located on the far west coast of Florida, Panama City Beach is known for its sugar-white beaches and resort attractions. Cool down your summer at Shipwreck Island, one of the most unique water parks in the nation. Enjoy a live show at Gulf World, hosted by some unlikely characters. If you're seeking adventure in the water, the inland lakes, coastal bays, and Gulf Front provide the perfect setting for snorkeling, windsurfing, or sailing. And both salt and freshwater fishing in the area are superb. No need to worry. Visitors can rent all the equipment needed for a super summer getaway. After sunset, the nighttime sizzles at Panama City Beach's clubs and cafes, and the food is unbeatable. For the trip you'll never forget, come to Panama City Beach. See you soon.
At the office. The pressure was really getting to me. My doctor told me if I didn't get some exercise, I'd be be a prime candidate for a heart attack.
Nordic Track.
I had a terrible time losing weight after my second baby, and dieting wasn't enough.
Nordic Track.
I really wanted to enjoy this time with my grandson, but I didn't have the energy to keep up.
Nordic Track duplicates cross-country skiing. It tones, develops, and conditions all the major muscles of your upper and lower body. Independent research shows users prefer Nordic Track more than 6-to-1 over exercise bikes and rowing machines. So it's a great way to get in shape, manage stress, and help control weight.
Nordic Track was just what I needed to work off stress.
With Nordic Track, I was able to lose weight and still eat regular meals.
Now I've got more pep.
For complete details on Nordic Track, call 1-800-432-9900. That's 1-800-432-9900.
Your day off to a great start with a hot cup of coffee and Folger's Waking Up Weather on the Weather Channel to get the accurate, up-to-the-minute regional weather conditions. Watch Folger's Waking Up Weather, sponsored by Vacuum Folgers, Monday through Friday mornings at 38 minutes past the hour between 6 and 10 a.m. Eastern. It's accurate, it's convenient, and it's only on the Weather Channel.
Original classic model contour chair, and I, Art Linkletter, will send you your choice of a fabulous 19-inch Panasonic color TV, microwave oven,
or VCR. But don't buy a contour chair for one of these.
Get one because it's the most restful, healthful chair you ever relaxed in. Contour chairs help to relieve low back pain, poor venous blood circulation in your legs, edema, and swelling of the legs.
Call toll-free and get full details on our fabulous offer.
I chose the Panasonic Color TV.
I took the VCR.
I got the microwave.
Hello. I'd like to have your catalog and certificate mailed to me free.
Certainly, sir.
See how easy it is? Call for your free catalog and certificate right away.
Call 1-800-858-3300. That's 1-800-858-3300. Toll free. Call 1-800-858-3300.
The 1990 Weather Folklore Calendar from the Weather Channel, one of the most sought-after calendars every year, is now available. It's filled with beautiful illustrations and timeless weather folklore on every page, and there's plenty of room to make notes for every day of the month. Order your 1990 Weather Folklore Calendar today. Call toll-free or send check or money order to Weather Calendars, Post Office Box 2030, Cameron Park, California, 95682. Calendars are just $8.95 each, plus $3 shipping and handling. Order your Weather Folklore Calendar now.
And we'll go ahead and take a look at some evening weather across the country. And it is definitely a wet one in the west, and it is going to wetten up across the upper Midwest and into the Plain States. Let's go ahead and take a satellite picture into motion. Let's take a look at Triton 1, and we'll show you the western United States is beginning to clear out. Here's a ridge of high pressure, but it's a dirty ridge, as we call it in meteorological terms. That means lots of moisture coming over the top. As it works its way into western Washington and Oregon, there will be some showers. But the brunt of this storm will be into British Columbia rather than California and Oregon, where 38 inches of snow fell at Donner's Summit during the past couple of days. And here's that major weather system pulling out. I'll move away so you can see where the bulk of the clouds and the showers and the storms are. Lots of rain and snow and a big low pressure beginning to strengthen as it works its way eastward. Things are definitely going to get worse before they get better in parts of South Dakota, into Minnesota, and across Wisconsin. Back to the maps, we'll indicate for you around the country where the current weather is right now. And it went by. Well, we'll look at some high temperatures. Put in the 172 map for me there, if you would, please. 39 for the high on Sunday in Bismarck, but it'll only be near 20 for a high on Monday. 29 for the high in Great Falls. 63 in Denver, turning cooler on Monday. 31 degrees for the high in Sault Ste. Marie. Here's the current map, and there it is, that low pressure pulling around. And there's the fog all over the southeast. Current temperatures, 30 in Duluth, 19 in Great Falls, 29 in Reno. Throw in the wind chills. Ooh, cold stuff. 11 degrees below zero is the way it feels in Rapid City, South Dakota. Radar, there it is, the rain and the snow. Even some rain in the northwest with that dirty ridge as it comes across into Oregon. Winter weather update. We'll highlight the particulars on the winter weather update, showing you the satellite picture from a different perspective. All this cloud cover now organizing across the central and northern parts of the nation. And again, that current map showing cold air as it rotates south out of Canada. Thanks a lot, Canada. We're bringing in all of the Saskatchewan and the Manitoba, all of that cold air up around the Hudson Bay. And as it rotates around this low pressure and pulls out, there's going to be a swath of snow from parts of the UP of Michigan, northwest Wisconsin, back into Minnesota, and eventually we'll see the 6 to 12 inches of snow in northern Wyoming as this continues to be a very serious storm for travel. Even some icy travel across Iowa into southern Wisconsin continuing on Monday. A little bit of snow around the northwest into Montana with that ridge again bringing some of the moisture over the top. Finally, by Monday night, there you go, the swath of snow including Milwaukee, Wisconsin, which, by the way, is where I am going. This is my last show here on the Weather Channel. Randy Frostick, nice enough to give me a Milwaukee Brewers shirt. I will become a fan. Randy, thank you very much. We'll look at local weather, and then we'll be back.
The current conditions. Tune for more weather coverage here on the Weather Channel.
Let's take a look at the maps in the morning hours across the west. We're still going to find some leftover snows from the western Rocky States all the way over into the country's midsection. High pressure replacing that nasty weather that gave you all that snow into the northern Sierra Nevada the last couple of days. Kirkwood, California coming in with 3 to 4 feet of new fresh powder for the skiers, and expecting some sunny skies to move into that region tomorrow. So bring along the sunscreen. It's going to be great skiing. Many of their lifts are open, we understand. Cascades of Washington still may pick up some snow in the afternoon hours and some lingering snows, but the heaviest will be again into the middle part of the nation. Lots of sunshine as you wake up into Southern California. Temperatures cool from Santa Maria all the way to Las Vegas. Look at the highs and the way they shape up in the afternoon. 60s and 70s and nice suntanning weather here. Heading northward, the fog along the coast may give you a problem. You may have to keep your low beams on in the morning. Very cool in the morning around Reno, but it warms up to 41 in the afternoon in the Tahoe Basin. We'll continue to see sunshine to finish out the day. Kind of gloomy, though, Pacific Northwest, 38 in Seattle in the morning. And keep the umbrella handy here. Some rain may be heavy. Cascade snows again. That keeps up in the afternoon hours, but some sunshine breaking out around Medford and Burns, Oregon. We'll take a look at much more weather information coming your way next. Yep.
Last year, my family and I were caught in weather like this. Our car slid off the road. But luckily, none of us were hurt. But this year, I've planned ahead with SureGrip cable chains.
When I need them, SureGrip cable chains go on quickly. And they come off neatly with just a tug on the strap.
The bottom line is safety. My family is prepared for any winter emergency with SureGrip cable chains.
Available at quality automotive retailers.
How wet did you get? Did you know that rainfall from a storm can vary tremendously from one town to the next? The best way to tell just how much rain you got is with a Weather Channel all-weather rain gauge from Seasonal Solutions. You can determine just how much water your lawn, garden, or crops have received and how much they still need. The all-weather rain gauge is a precision weather instrument, measures all kinds of precipitation, and it's just $24.95 plus $4 shipping and handling. Your satisfaction's guaranteed.
To order the Weather Channel all-weather rain gauge by credit card, call 1-800-322-2100. Call now.
It is time now for the Michelin Driver's Report. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires. Now we'll check out the snowy travel as we head on into the early part of the morning. Minneapolis, St. Paul, we are forewarning you that it will be a slow go in the snow. If not early, by later in the morning, the swath of snow will extend across northern Minnesota, back up into parts of Wisconsin. And the problem will not only be the snow, but to the south of the cold front, into the air, which is not quite as cold, there will be some areas of ice, freezing rain, and sleet.
Honey, I think it's time we got a new set of Michelins.
Couldn't we save a little on a cheaper brand?
Well, our last set of Michelins got over 60,000 miles.
We've got to watch every penny now that Becky's going away to college.
Yeah, but you know, there's one thing more important than putting Becky through college.
What's that?
Making sure she gets there.
Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you, because so much is riding on your tires.
Just about 56 now after the hour, I'm Kam Karma alongside Dan Pope for the last time here at the Weather Channel. We wish him all the luck. Here is his last segment.
Thanks very much, Kam. And indeed, a humbling experience to be at the last of an epic. Last of a Weather Channel era, I suppose you might say. Anyway, let's check out some radars. You don't want to hear my sad story or my happy story. Heading off to Milwaukee, Wisconsin, where it's raining right now. Once again, advertising the Milwaukee Brewers. The folks here kind enough to give me a Milwaukee shirt to send me off in a nice fashion. Let's zoom in and show you some scattered showers over Florida. We'll move back up towards the Midwest and indicate some areas of snow with wind chills 10 below zero in Rapid City. Also from Pierre over towards Aberdeen and down to Huron. More in the way of rain here, but it'll all turn over to snow before the night is through, as we continue to monitor a serious situation as this upper low and a surface low moves eastward. About 6 to 8 inches of snow will fall over towards Minneapolis, St. Paul.
Welcome to Sunday's Primetime Tonight, your inside look at cable TV. Coming to you every half hour during your primetime viewing hours. The dramatic programs and comedy specials. Miami Vice keeps you moving on USA. A sexy socialite wins her husband's team in First and Ten on HBO. Discovery Sunday takes a look at lighthouses on the Discovery Channel. Check out Laugh-In on Nickelodeon. A&B Diamond Showcase presents Judy Collins at the Toronto Forum. Next on USA, Crockett and Tubbs stay tough on crime in Miami Vice. Here are the sports coming this half hour. TNN brings you Championship Rodeo. In progress on ESPN is the College Basketball 89 Maui Classic Championship game. Coming up on TNN, don't miss the excitement of bronc and bull riding in Championship Rodeo.
Look at the bullfighter. Schuster staying on his feet. Jimmy's staying right there. Wow! Right into the barrel.
The finest in music and variety programs are coming up. Showtime presents Paul McCartney, Put It There. Now showing on the Disney Channel is Lake Wobegon Loyalty Days. Coming up next on the Disney Channel, Garrison Keillor creates a special piece called Lake Wobegon Loyalty Days. News and the latest weather in just 1 minute. Orthopedic surgery update for physicians is on Lifetime. On the Weather Channel is your local forecast. For an informed look at events, watch Headline News. Later tonight on the Weather Channel, get the 24-hour forecast and the extended forecast for conditions in your area. Now, here's a recap of the shows coming up in just a few moments. Primetime Tonight. We'll be back in 27 minutes with more cable TV highlights. Stay tuned now to the Weather Channel for your local forecast.
Thanks for joining us here at the Weather Channel. I'm Rich Johnson. With me is Mike Bono. And after I'm done looking at the satellite picture, he'll be looking at Monday's snowy forecast for the upper Midwest. Satellite picture, as we put into the motion, watch all the clouds slide over through the Rockies. A lot of snow was dropped, especially in the Wasatch, Central California, Sierra. We're talking about 2-3 feet, even more than that, of snow totals. The southwestern states, a bit of a different story. Generally high pressure here, but if you look closely, you can see the Sierra here. These aren't clouds. Those are some of the, or the leftover snow that's still in the higher peaks of the Sierra. Way out to the west, that's the next frontal system. That won't be affecting the Washington and Oregon coast probably until the next 48 hours, but that front will be coming close enough to bring some more rain and possibly even some snow showers for the Cascades. Meanwhile, this is going to be pushing out into the Rockies.
This is Weather Watch.
Thanks for joining us here at the Weather Channel. I'm Rich Johnson, and this is Mike Bono. And boy, do we have a big winter storm cranked up. It's already dumped a lot of snow, Mike.
Compliments of the West Coast and the Rockies now headed for the Northern Plains. We'll take a look at that forecast for you for early morning Monday. A tough enough day to get back to work for some of you after the four-day weekend. And oh, rough go in the snow. You may want to call it a five-day weekend if you can have that luxury on into the upper Midwest. We're talking snow now in a lot of western South Dakota, already heading up toward Fargo. Snow really beginning to come down, reduce visibility around Rapid City, and that's moving right on into a lot of Minnesota. By morning, on into parts of Wisconsin too, a surge of warm air, rain mixing with snow, a battle zone, some sleet in the middle in the Great Lakes, and high pressure hanging tough for a while longer in the northeast, as the southeast is quite overcast and foggy in your morning hours. Northerly winds, though, dragging the cool air down through the Great Plains, and a little taste of moisture again. Western Washington, some rain and Cascade snows. But the good news from a lot of Oregon down through the southwest, very rapidly and thankfully improving weather situation. We'll move that storm on eastward midday, late day. The snows end in the Dakotas and a good chunk of Minnesota, and in their place, cold air coming on down. The snow really cranking around Lake Superior, and the rain and milder air washing up into the east as some weak impulses come into the northern Rockies with some snow. How much precipitation? Well, over a half an inch in many spots, even some of that into South Florida. And we're looking at the snow totaling up to more than 6 inches, centering on Wyoming, South Dakota, Minnesota, and northern parts of Wisconsin. Here's that temperature forecast. Read it and weep, or look at it and shiver in a lot of the northern plains. Much milder and stickier on into the Southland. We're looking at a surge of 70s up the Mississippi Valley, though, for Monday, and some much, much cooler and snowier weather on into the northern prairies. Some mildness in the southwest desert. Your local weather followed by the look ahead in the jet stream.
It's time to look at the forecast for the week ahead, and we're going to be starting with the jet stream. And boy, is there a big ridge in the west. Look at the jet, how it dips by Friday. This means very cold temperatures in the east, while the west, especially the southwest, is going to be enjoying very warm temperatures. As we look at Tuesday's temps, look at the southeast, 80s, 70s, 60s, very warm. That's because the frontal system will be situated through the Tennessee River Valley, pushing toward the Gulf Coast. Behind the front, plenty of cold air, teens and 20s. These are the high temperatures too. The southwest enjoying some very nice weather. Los Angeles in the mid 70s, real good to start off the week. As we progress into the middle of the week, we still have the very cold air way to the north heading into Thursday, but we'll see the next frontal system dropping down toward the end of the week. Here's the next batch of cold air. Don't be surprised if the temperatures here aren't even a little bit chillier. Meanwhile, the southwestern states, Los Angeles, San Francisco, still looking very nice. The weather for Tuesday in the west, a large area, high pressure dominating, maybe some breezes from the east, Southern California, but the eastern section of the country, storm system heading off the coast, and just a few leftover snow showers toward the midsection of the week. The west mainly dry through the rest of the week, and Friday basically dry here with a few snow showers for the northern plains, or I should say the Great Lakes into Maine later on Friday. Stick around because we'll have satellite pictures and your 5-day business planner coming up.
Now for the first time on television, SMI's fantastic free cassette offer. The convenient condensation of Napoleon Hill's classic motivational masterwork, Think and Grow Rich. Call now. It's absolutely free. 1-800-452-7700. You'll gain self-confidence, improve your concentration, stimulate your subconscious, generate your imagination, master procrastination, multiply your brain power, turn your desires into reality. You will literally think and grow rich. Why does SMI make this amazing offer? Because people who are interested in Think and Grow Rich and other personal development materials are often the same people who are interested in knowing about SMI International's total line of programs and the unique business opportunity we offer. What do you have to lose? Call 1-800-452-7700 and start to think and grow rich.
Your day off to a great start with a hot cup of coffee and Folger's Waking Up Weather on the Weather Channel to get the accurate, up-to-the-minute regional weather conditions. Watch Folger's Waking Up Weather, sponsored by Vacuum Folgers, Monday through Friday mornings at 38 minutes past the hour between 6 and 10 a.m. Eastern. It's accurate, it's convenient, and it's only on the Weather Channel.
How wet did you get? Did you know that rainfall from a storm can vary tremendously from one town to the next? The best way to tell just how much rain you got is with a Weather Channel all-weather rain gauge from Seasonal Solutions. You can determine just how much water your lawn, garden, or crops have received and how much they still need. The all-weather rain gauge is a precision weather instrument, measures all kinds of precipitation, and it's just $24.95 plus $4 shipping and handling. Your satisfaction's guaranteed.
To order the Weather Channel all-weather rain gauge by credit card, call 1-800-322-2100. Call now.
Driving Tips is sponsored by Radio Chain, the premium quality cable chain that installs in minutes and is best for radial tires.
In winter, I wouldn't think of going anywhere without buckling our seatbelts or without taking cable chains, ones I know I can put on myself. And because I use radial tires, I insist on the original radial chain. They go on easily and they hold securely. Some things aren't worth the risk. I always use my seatbelt, and I always carry the original radial chain.
Available at quality automotive retailers.
Now here's Bruce Edwards.
Most of us think it's always the other guy who gets stuck or has an accident, but winter weather puts everyone on the road at risk for an emergency. If it happened to you, would you have anything on hand to deal with the special complications of a winter accident?
Now's the time to pack a winter survival kit. You can start with safety kits that already include the basics, a spotlight and tire inflator, safety flares and jumper cables. For protection against cold, add old blankets, hats, a long-burning candle with a metal can and matches. You'll get a surprising amount of warmth from a candle stuck in a can. To deal with heavy snow or ice, you'll need a steel shovel and a bag of sand or cat litter for traction. Emergency tire chains are also a good idea. Check with your auto dealership for the safety kits and emergency equipment. You should be able to pull the rest together with 30 minutes at home and a short trip to the hardware store. Then when it's your turn to be the other guy, you won't be caught cold. I'm Bruce Edwards for the Weather Channel.
The 1990 calendars from the Weather Channel are now available. The Weather Guide calendar has page after page of interesting and unusual photographs, and there are phenomenal weather events described in detail for each day of the year. The 1990 Weather Guide is a fascinating collection of weather information for the whole family, with interesting articles on important environmental issues. The 1990 Weather Folklore calendar is beautifully illustrated. Each page has a painting reflecting the weather of that month, with a sampling of weather folklore traced from as far back as the Egyptian culture of 3500 BC. Both calendars have plenty of room on each day to write important notes. The 1990 Weather Guide calendar and the 1990 Weather Folklore calendar make great gifts. Here's how to order. To order by credit card, call toll-free or send your name and address along with $8.95 per calendar plus $3 shipping and handling per order to Weather Calendars, Post Office Box 2030, Cameron Park, California 95682. Be sure to specify the calendar or calendars of your choice. Order your calendars now.
For the Days In 5-Day Business Planner, keeping track of storm systems, hazardous weather, and poor road conditions that may affect your business travel. The Days In 5-Day Business Planner, coming up in just a few minutes, right here on the Weather Channel.